YouTube and fellow DC comic fans. I'm Kelly One Shot, and this is my cat. And today is Wednesday, December 5th, and you know what that means. It's New Comic Book Day. So I'm going to quickly go over the new comic books that just came out today, and the ones I recommend you pick up as well. We're going to start this off with Batman and the Max number 3. I have all three books, and I haven't read the first two, but the Max is an Image Comics character from the 90s, and he's doing a crossover with Batman. I'm going to probably read them after all 6 issues come out. As I said, this is Batman and the Max. Check it out if you're interested in the Max. If you're interested in Batman, it might be good too. But if you have no interest in either, then don't pick it up. Like I said, I'm going to read that as they all come out. But I do have them all, so we'll see what happens in Batman the Max number 3. There's that. Okay, my cat loves this next book. This is Green Lantern number 2, written by Grant Morrison. This series has been really fun so far. I mean, we are only on the second issue. I do like how they kind of started off the story so far, and I can't wait to see what happens with our friend Hal Jordan of the Green Lantern Corps. It's kind of like a soft reset a little bit. Not really. It continues the story, but it's kind of taking on a new angle. DC Comics, like I said before, and we've talked about in the past, and as you surely know yourself, they're kind of doing like softy reboots, mid-rebirth. They're not really calling it rebirth. I'm not exactly sure, though we do still have a lot of rebirth numbering, and Doomsday Clock is still going on, which is the beef and the meat and potatoes of rebirth to begin with, especially since Wally West is gone, or is he? Let's find out in Heroes in Crisis number 4 when that comes out. I'm sure we won't find out in that issue. But either way, that is Green Lantern number 2, written by Grant Morrison. Okay, the next book that I got today is a book that we all feel a little iffy on, as we love this character. I'm sure you love him as much as I do. And that is Nightwing. This is Nightwing number 54. And as you see on the cover, it says question mark. Nightwing question mark? And I can't help but agree, because this doesn't feel like Nightwing in the last 4 or 5 issues or so. It's ever since he got shot in the head from the KG Beast in Batman. Now he's going by Rick Grayson, and we all hate that. You hear us, Dan DiDio? You hear us, DiDio? We hate it. Stop getting rid of the legacy characters. Stop messing with Nightwing. Stop messing with Arsenal. Stop messing with Wally West. What is wrong with you, DiDio? Stop it. We need Geoff Johns back at the helm. I don't know what we need, but we need to stop doing these bad things. But like I said to my local comic book shop owner, I actually have been reading Nightwing way more than I have, even though I loathe this current Rick Grayson arc. But I can't wait to see what happens, because I want to see how they fix it, if they fix it, or how badly they ruin it. Nightwing number 54, question mark? Okay. The next book that I got is written by James Tynion IV, and that is the first Justice League book post-Drowned Earth. That is Justice League number 13, as I said, written by James Tynion IV. I don't know when Scott Snyder's going to jump back into this series. Maybe in the next issue? I don't know. I'm sure that they have it written down. But either way, this is the first issue post the Drowned Earth saga, which you could read in Titans and Aquaman and Justice League and Aquaman and Justice League and Aquaman and Justice League. Either way, this is Justice League number 13. I think we're going to deal with the Legion of Doom, as we've been fighting the Legion of Doom a lot lately. This might be the issue that Joker steps up, as he is a member of the Legion of Doom. Okay, the next book that I got is written by Tom King, and that is Batman number 60. As I said, there's still rebirth numbering. This is still a rebirth numbered book, and I still fully believe that we are in DC Rebirth, because they haven't given us a new header. I know they tried pushing the new age of superheroes with like Sideways and Damage and Brimstone and all those people, the Immortal Men and all that stuff. Not all those characters are hitting well. And I think some of them might even be done already, to be honest with you. I don't really know. Either way, this is Batman number 60. Batman has been working with the Penguin. Well, the Penguin has been telling him that Bane is running Arkham from the inside. And in the last issue, Batman went to Arkham to confront Bane. And Bane was like, Mommy, Mommy, no. He was playing it up and hamming it up as if he was a victim. And even Jim Gordon and everybody else believed that Bane was truly this weakened state character now. But at the end of the issue, after he's bloody and beaten, and Jim Gordon kicks Batman out of Arkham Asylum, Bane smiled. And we know that Bane is working with all the other villains, as it was at the end of the wedding, where we saw there was like the Skeet robot who was Booster Gold, there was the Flashboy Thomas Wayne looking Batman, there was Psycho Pirate, I believe, is still there as well, and Bane was sitting on like a throne of skulls or something like that. It's a lot going on in Tom King's run since I Am Gotham, I Am Bane, you know, all that fun stuff. Speaking of I Am Gotham, I hear that Gotham Girl is going to be in Heroes in Crisis, maybe number 4 or maybe an issue after that, but she might even be one of the people who had something to do with it. Let's find out in the next issue. Speaking of Heroes in Crisis, that last issue was really great, really emotional, and I loved reading it and seeing more of Wally West and his perspective on the situation. Well, pre him dying, that is. And we even saw some Lagoon Boy and some Commander Steel, which everybody's sleeping on them because no one's like, oh, I'm mad because Lagoon Boy died. Well, guess what? Neptune's beard. I'm mad that Lagoon Boy's dead. How about that? Yeah, either way. So yeah, like I said, this is Batman number 60 written by Tom King. Check it out. Definitely going to read that very soon. Very, very, very soon. Okay, these last two books are also written by Geoff Johns. I do want to give an honorable mention to Martian Manhunter number 1, written by Steve Orlando. They didn't have any more extra copies of it at my comic book shop, and since it's a newer title, I forgot that it was coming out this week, so I didn't put it on my poll, and that's just what happens. Sometimes when you don't put a book on your poll, you don't get it. So I'm going to have to get it, you know what I mean, down the road as it gets reissued and all that stuff. Either way, that came out today. Check it out. That is Martian Manhunter's solo book number 1, written by Steve Orlando. I guess he's kind of local from what my comic book shop owner says. Either way, this next book is written by Geoff Johns, and it is the return of a character that maybe we all love. I love him, at least. My dude, Captain Marvel, the real Captain Marvel, a.k.a. Shazam! Billy Batson, this is Shazam number 1, written by Geoff Johns. Can't wait to read it. Very excited. Let's see what happens, as I don't think Shazam has had a solo run since the New 52. And that was a long time ago at this point, because it's 2018. Either way, very excited. Love Geoff Johns' writing style. Love his work. Cannot wait to read Shazam! Looks pretty good, huh? Alright, the last book that I got, and like I said before, it is the meat and potatoes that is DC Rebirth. It's the story that takes place 2 years in the future from where DC Rebirth is happening. Either way, I still have to read the last issue, the one with Rorschach number 2. He's like, he's down punching or something like that. You know the one. You know the issue. Either way, this is Doomsday Clock number 8. Wow! We were actually, when they originally announced Doomsday Clock, we would have been done in November this year. But with all the pushbacks and the pushbacks, we still got 4 issues left. Check out them nails. They look pretty good, huh? I like them. Either way, Doomsday Clock number 8, as we see the puppets on the strings being pulled, Ozymandias' hands, Dr. Manhattan, Superman, they're the puppets battling each other, and Ozymandias is pulling the strings. Let's see what happens. Cannot wait. Gonna honestly have to check out, what is it, not number 7. I'm gonna have to rewatch a video that I did a review of for number 6, and then I'm gonna read number 7, and then I'm gonna read this, because it's so long from when they come out that you kind of like lose your place a little bit, and I haven't yet read number 7 because I've been slacking, hardcore slacking, because I have a lot going on in my life. That's no excuse. Either way, Doomsday Clock number 8 of 12. Cannot wait to read it. Geoff Johns wrote it. Amazing. Gary Frank is still doing the art, I believe. He is. He's amazing too. Love his work. Check out this book. You need to get it. It's Doomsday Clock number 8. Either way, I'm Kelly OneShot. My cat is not here anymore. Take care. Have a great day. And goodbye.